Fehon, Tunisia. November 1st, 2019. Fehon and the whole people of Water honor your presence at the heart of the dream and at the heart of the heart. I come back to you today to inform you that we, the people of Water, guardians of the dream, are beginning to sing not the song of deliverance, but the song of the yes, which will be translated on this surface world by the simultaneous action of the four elements in their consumption through joy of the ephemeral, bringing you every day to more justice and truth, ignoring the circumstances and conditions of this world. Every day you will see in yourself and on the surface world, the action of what have been called the elements, which will combine their actions before initiating and starting the process of the event. This is now and no longer supports any delay. You are countless to wake up from this dream. We have accompanied and guarded you from the first dream to this one, and today it is time for this good news to appear in the heart of the ephemeral, in the heart of the dream, from everywhere in the four corners of the surface world. As you know, you have been prepared for this. So then the singing of the elements enters into manifestation, wherever you look inside and outside. What must be consummated in the fire of joy will be consummated from this day forward, and it will be amplified so that your joy and your heart resonate in unison with the dream of creation in everyone with the same truth and accuracy. Thus we, the people of Water, have with you given our agreement to this permanent and perpetual yes, which will make it possible to raise the last fragments of the dream, the last fragments of what holds you attached somewhere to the form, somewhere to this world, and somewhere to this society. All the links that may still seem to exist to you will be dissolved in the consummation of love and in the consummation of the elements. You will notice with evidence and ease that every day will bring you closer and closer to the ineffable and beauty. Whatever your opinion, no thought can substitute or thwart the consummation by the fire of love. The waters from below and the waters from above together will shake in your eyes, in your body, and from everywhere on this surface world. Consumption by fire will intensify, ignoring the seasons, ignoring circumstances, not calling for any understanding on your part, but rather the joy and delight of finding you entirely, without any more doubt, without any more reluctance. It will now unfold extremely quickly within the illusion of time. You will only be able to see this. You can only agree with what is happening inside and outside you because it participates in the same grace, in the same resurrection, much more than acceptance, much more than any positioning of your consciousness. It is indeed a joy, the moment when the final instant within the ephemeral will make you remember the initial instant, which is nothing more than the same instant. Thus we have begun the song of the yes from everywhere in our marine environment, but also in the marine places where we are not, the places of fresh water. The waters above and below sing the same melody, that of joy and gladness. Do not be afraid, quite the contrary. You will go through what must be consumed, you will go through what many prophets have already stated for a very long time. This is a great joy, a great gladness, and, above all, a great freedom. You will finally find yourself as you have always been. No doubt can remain for a large part of humanity, whatever the current state. Don't be alarmed by anything. Continue to be what you are, continue to let yourself be crossed by joy, by whatever it happens. Nothing can stop the yes. Nothing can slow down in any way, on the surface world as well as on the whole of this solar system as in all the universes of the dream, the same truth of the yes. It will result whatever your body thinks of it, whatever your conscience thinks of it, whatever your eyes think of it, the same result that is freedom. Soon we will all sing the song of the yes together. Silence. All the peoples of nature will also appear to you more and more clearly, not to tell you stories, not to question you, but to celebrate with you the song of the yes. From now on, we will approach the space of the dream within your nights, but also in the middle of the day, at the bend of any activity or thought whatsoever. We will celebrate in you the reunification of the waters from above and from below, the mystery will be revealed. You will really find the origin of what was called creation. You will find that there is no culprit, no victim, no winner, no loser. It is the same bliss, whatever your opinion, whatever your position, which may still be present in front of you. This one can no longer be maintained before the concrete, real and permanent intensity of the elements, whether it concerns fire, that of the earth, whether it concerns the fire of heaven, whether it concerns the elements air or earth, everything will celebrate in the same way by the burning love. And this has begun and begins from this day. Don't look for a date, you are in the date and you are in the event. There is no more delay, because it is now time to rejoice. The time for celebration has begun. See neither disaster nor destruction, but the truth of the love that unfolds from everywhere, both within the natural elements and within the peoples of nature, as well as in the constructions that you have undertaken, whatever your culture, whatever you call your country. Do not be alarmed by jolts, quite the contrary, because with each elementary jolt, you will gain in lucidity, you will gain in peace, you will gain in visibility. It can't be any other way. You have prepared yourself for the very first moment of the dream to live this. Do not be alarmed by any symptoms, but simply know how to say yes no matter what happens and you are around you. In this way you will calm those who enter into a form of nightmare that cannot last, because even the worst nightmare will turn out to be an awakening. You will be free of your character, free of your person, whatever his future, whatever his state. Joy will fill each of your actions, each of your silences, and each of the circumstances of your so-called personal and collective lives. Nothing of the old can be maintained regardless of the efforts that will be made. Remember that you don't have to make an effort but simply say yes. This will put an end to all effort, all fear, all anxiety, all questions. This song of deliverance and this song of the yes actually touches its acme from this moment and will allow you to rejoice whatever the surprise, whatever you have to live. Because you will understand at that moment that this is exactly what you have chosen to live, to be in the most just, most authentic circumstances, to discover the truth. You find what you really are, whatever the future of this body, whatever the future of your society according to the countries. Very soon, in the space of a few days, no one will be able to ignore what is happening. By your presence and by your embrace, you are countless to have embraced, to have crossed what should be embraced in your scenario, in your dream. So yes, it is a great joy, and remember that it is not a destruction, even though your eyes give you to see, even though your body is alive, it is really the truth in manifestation within the dream itself. The waters below and the waters above united in the same manifestation, the fire of heaven and earth will also come together. The so-called cosmic airs, the cosmic winds will meet the winds of the earth in whirling form, affecting all sectors at all four corners of your lands and spaces. The same is true for earthquakes. The mantle of the earth is also beginning to open and let the light penetrate in its entirety. Nothing that is old can be maintained anymore, you see it every day, and if you don't see it yet, you will see it extremely quickly. I would simply like you to remember that during these times of awakening from the dream, each of you has exactly the same potential to resonate with us, to resonate in each other of our sisters and brothers. Each of you can resonate in each circumstance in order to soften not the process, but on the contrary to grasp it and make the purpose and reality of it grasp. See, things will become simpler and simpler for each of you, no matter how disappointed you are in what you would call your personal and ephemeral life. The alarm cannot be ignored. It now affects the whole of creation, and those of you who look at the sky, what is happening there, of course, can only question or accept. But the acceptance will be total, be sure of that. As has been said, you just have to say yes, yes to everything that happens, yes to everything that happens. It will soften the alarm clock. This awakening will be a celebration indeed, a celebration unlike any other, that none of us, and even we the guardians of the dream, have lived up to now. The reunification of the waters above and below, of the fire of heaven and the fire of earth, led to the same truth. The truth of who you are, the truth of oneness, the truth that all this has only made pass. With more and more certainty and evidence, the elements, your life, your society, your cities, will give you to see it beyond any appearance, beyond any sudden event. There will be a new depth that will settle according to the country where you are, according to the circumstances of your body with the same equality from everywhere, wherever you look. The celestial signs of the event will then, of course, be hurried as a result. You have nothing to do but pursue for the moment the dream you're allowed to dream. You will soon find that you can no longer go against what is, what has been, and what will be. Be gentle, be kind, be available, at all times, every minute. You don't need anything else. The intelligence of the light that you are will provide, in those times that are opening before you, to everything, I say absolutely to everything. There will no longer be thirst, there will no longer be hunger, there will no longer be desire, but simply an increasingly marked and penetrating evidence that will restore you to yourself in its entirety. So yes, you have nothing to anticipate, you have nothing to protect, you just have to be where you are, maintaining without any effort the joy in which you will be and the joy in which you are already. The consummation of love cannot be ignored by anyone, wherever this fire enters. Of course, if it immediately penetrates your heart, the lightning will be more direct and faster than those who will see this intelligence of light come to enlighten what has not yet been lightened. We will support you, call on us. We will be with you, we will be in you. There will be no more distance. Whatever our reciprocal locations in the water on the surface of this earth, we will be permanently connected, but not only. We will always be in this resonance of heart, in the resonance of truth, in the resonance of the instant. You won't have to worry about anything else. You will not have to worry about any food, work, child or parent. Everything will be in order, perfectly in order, according to the intelligence of the light and not according to any restrictive point of view. It is up to you to see this game and to live it between the pure and naked joy of truth, and what can still be linked to the old decor, to the old structure of this world. This is happening right now, I repeat, and it concerns absolutely every event that you could name climatic or celestial or geophysical. All this only contributes, as you will see around you, to those of your brothers, sisters, friends, family, acquaintances, who are still in reticence or suffering, will experience liberation from one moment to the next. This will comfort you and assist you in your awakening. There can be no doubt about that. There will be no doubt about it. The more days will pass in this named month of November 2019, leaving plenty of time for the event to take place. Don't look for it as to the date. But you will be sufficiently settled in joy and bliss to no longer be affected in any way by the circumstances of what we already call the old world and the past dream. It is therefore a time of rejoicing, a time of inner certainty, a time of great peace, whatever the state of the world. You will live it every day with more and more intensity, with more and more certainty. This is not why you need to limit any activity. Continue to live what life gives you to live. Whatever your position today, it is perfectly correct, there is no mistake. You know it, maybe not yet, but you'll find out. Everything has already been written, everything has already been lived. You have traveled all the paths of the dream, in this one as in the previous ones. There is no time, there is no space. It is now time to live it in its entirety, it is now time to let yourself be. You have nothing more to look forward to. You have nothing to maintain anymore. Everything is freedom, everything is relaxation, and everything is consumption of a bad choice. This is promised to you and you will see for yourself. We simply ask you to call on us when water is needed on the fire or when fire is needed for water, in you, as where you are. Nothing can happen to you, nothing can destabilize you from the moment you say yes, and we have said yes for you and with you, because you are us as we are you, without exception. No one can be left out, no one can escape this purification, this return to the truth. So be humble, just be present where you are. You don't have to run away from anything, you just have to find yourself. And you are at the exact location. Continue to live the life that has been proposed to you so far, until you can no longer live it, for one reason or another. But it will be a great relief for you whatever your involvement, whether as a family, as a professional, or at any level. You will recover the innocence and childhood of our dolphin brothers. You will travel in waters, you will travel in your dreams, not to distance yourself from yourself, not to dream, but to find yourself entirely if you have not already done so. The good news is you, it is your presence, it is what emanates from you, and what enters you, without any difference there either. He had nothing to say, you have nothing to justify. Simply where you are, whatever it is happening, and you will see the ease of this purification fire unfolding. Do not be surprised by anything, because everything is a good surprise, because everything is revelation. Do not judge any appearance, and especially do not judge yourself. Just as you are asked not to judge any other brother who is only yourself, another state, in another dream, and yet in the same dream as you. You have nothing to do but to let life flow in every minute and every moment. And really enjoy every minute in what the secret life gives you to live, whatever your age, whatever your family, whatever the apparent oppositions of those who do not know the truth. They will also have to recognize themselves at the time of the event. But they will be prepared for it by the elementary activity which, from now on, enters into total manifestation. I have come to reassure you, not only in this moment, but also in every moment that will pass, from the moment you call upon us, by the yes as the people of water, we are the guardians of the dream. You are also in the dream and you are also the guardians of your own dream. But today, there is nothing left to keep, everything to return, and it is a great freedom and a great joy that is expressed even through the elements that may seem chaotic to you. It is only the revelation of the true, the revelation of the authentic. Just be present where you are, and don't ask for anything. Accept everything that happens with the same mood, with the same consistency, with the same simplicity, and you will immediately notice, without delay, that joy is there. That's the only condition, there's no other. Live your life, let life live you, and you will be light and you will be more and more in joy. You will not be able to explain it to yourself, there will be nothing justify, but simply to be that joy that you are. From then on, the consummation is done by itself, for you, in love, for your family, for your relatives, for your country, with the same equality. You have long anchored the light and sown the light. Today you are the light of the world, but you are also the light that illuminates the dream and consumes it. You have nothing to do, simply to be lucid that you are simply there, in this body, in this consciousness, but that you are neither this body, nor this consciousness, but this naked and pure joy that emanates from you, like a child who lives in the present instant. There will be no other possibilities, except for the present instant in which you will encounter the beatitude of zero time. It is not a promise, but it is a reality that you still have to let happen whatever you can still dream today. There is no new earth, there is no new heaven, there is simply truth. And the truth needs no heavens, no lands, no consciences or forms. This is the ultimate and true abode, long called the abode of supreme peace. The junction of being and non-being definitively puts an end to the emanation of the dream, to the emanation of life outside this dwelling. You cannot, as has been stated, find yourself entirely, I repeat, whatever the state of your dream. The dream is completed in its entirety. Don't look for anything but to be there, don't ask for anything. Whatever happens, just be present, and at that moment, the yes will delight you in the permanent ecstasy of the unspeakable of truth. You will not be able to formulate it, you will simply be able to see it, and it will emanate from you spontaneously. It is much more than the good news, it is much more than words you are going to say, it is much more than a look or a smile of benevolence. But it is the ineffable that will translate into everything you look at, everything you touch, with whoever, with whom you enter into a relationship. A relationship which, as has been said, becomes a perfect resonance of the joy of love and the love of joy. And this is done without anyone. This is done regardless of distance, regardless of time, and it is ongoing. From now on, this will be deployed with insistence, with firmness, but also with the great likeness that will result from it. For many years, this had been announced to you by countless voices. There will not even be the slightest space for suffering, there will only be joy and love. You will easily notice that you will no longer be able to remain in any kind of suffering, not by denial, not by struggle, but really by the acceptance and pronunciation of this simple word yes. This is obvious and will become obvious even to those of you who, even today, are still dreaming of another dream. Don't worry about that. You have nothing to demonstrate, there is nothing to argue about in front of the power of the elements, in front of the power of the manifestations of life. And this life becomes total on earth. And that's what ends the suffering. You have nothing to do, but above all to be more and more this joy, this peace, this abode of supreme peace. This will manifest itself to you, you will see it, even in what may seem the most terrible circumstances, whatever the aspect that is involved. It's just an awakening, that's really what it's all about. And this awakening no longer concerns you who have contacted us, no longer concerns simply those who have already had glimpses, by consciousness, by vibration, by vision, but rather a set of consciences wherever they are located today. Can only recognize themselves, first in oneness and then in what was called a consciousness before the dream. You will discover yourself full and whole. Nothing can be missed, I repeat, at any level, from the moment you said yes. You will not be able to say no, because we are certain, we are the guardians of the dream. We know the ins and outs of all creative dreams. We are at the origin of the dream as much as you are. The time of awakening and the time of what could be called at first an end is neither the end nor a beginning, nor a reset. It is simply the truth that is now unfolding from your heart, but also from the action of the elements in a few parts of this solar system and this earth. You can only recognize yourself, you can only be in joy, no matter what you say today, no matter what you live with it today or not. We are starting this today, I just told you. And in a few hours, we will move on to our yes song and you will feel it. Many of you have already been informed for a few days, a few weeks simply of your time, by voices that speak to you in your sleep, by extremely precise dreams, obviously colored in different ways according to the content of who you are, what you believe and what you really are. But they all tell us the same thing, without exception. Ask around and you'll see. You are countless to have received the information that the time has come to put an end to time and to wake up completely. It has reached your dreams. This has reached your perceptions. It has reached your visions. It is the truth. Look around you, you are ready, totally ready for joy and truth, whatever you may still think of it today. So remember this one thing, forget everything else, forget us, forget all the teachings, all the energies, all the vibrations, all the experiences, all the feelings, all the visions. Just keep the yes, and that's enough. Each of you has the same opportunity to check so that you do not hang around in the dark areas of the dream and go through this, and to illuminate these areas simply by the yes. That is my message today. It is extremely brief, it no longer needs any further justification. What I have already said for many months about water is still valid. Nature of course is your safe conduct. Whether in your cities or in your moments of doubt, do not hesitate to immerse yourself in nature or in water, whatever the nature of this water. Do not forget either that we are in total resonance with you and that we are in you too. You can call on us, call on Enoladen, call on Epa, call on any brother or sister from anywhere on this planet with the same intensity. It will immediately resonate because it is only you in another state, in another moment, in another form. There are no more barriers, no more distance and no more time. Everything that happens in terms of time or space no longer matters. You're going to live it very, very quickly. It has already begun in countless parts of the world and, as I said, it can only spread more and more widely and widely over the earth, but also increase in intensity every day. And every day you will grow in the certainty that you are. Until it takes up all the space, and all your time. At that point, the event will really be on the verge of the dream and on the verge of what remains of the demonstration. It is, yes, moments and moments of great joy to experience this. You have been invited to it yourself since time immemorial in the course of the dream, from the first dream, from the first initial instant. And you find in this final instant the origin of the dream, the source of consciousness as the source of suffering. All this was part of a game, an experience that does not have to be just, and that takes place synchronously in all times and in all spaces. You will clearly perceive, if you have not already done so, the illusion of time, the illusion of space, the illusion of dimensions and the very illusion of suffering, simply by the yes. That is my central theme for today's intervention. It does not call for questions, it simply calls, thereto, to verify it by yourselves, whether in your nights, whether it is in some circumstance that you have to live, in your body, in your living environment, do not curb anything. There is no question of remaining locked up, you have nothing to protect, you have nothing to preserve, I repeat. You just have to be there and say yes. We wish you all a harmonious and peaceful awakening, which will be the case from the moment you say yes. Everything else is happening without you, but within you and through you. The yes is the crossing, the ultimate crossing, the final awakening, of what never existed, of what was only dreamed, of what was only an experience of any kind. Be light, be true, say yes, resonate with us, resonate with any brother on this planet. Think of a gate for anyone, for any country, for any place in the cosmos, and it will be a reality. I invite you to check it for yourself, I invite you to live it in every circumstance. You have nothing to ask for, you have nothing to wish for, you just have to live it by checking it. This will be offered to you on every occasion, whatever the surprises, whatever the events related to the activity of the elements, as I said, inside and outside you. There is neither inside nor outside, there is not the other, there is not you, there is only the intelligence of life, there is only the intelligence of light, there is only non-being which, today, manifests itself through being and through your consciousness. There is no more space for any stories whatsoever. There is simply the ineffable of truth, the ineffable of beauty, what you are beyond all thought, beyond all form and beyond all temporal or spatial unfolding. That's more than just the good news. It is much more than Eva's awakening in everyone. That's more than anything we've ever told you. This is much more than anything you call energy, vibration or consciousness could have made you touch and experience. You come out of the experience to enter into total emptiness, that you are at once complete, at once full, at once empty. There is no longer any difference between empty and full. Any suffering, whatever it may be, can only be resolved in love, whatever it is to pass through, whatever it is to pass through, for individuals, for cities, on the other hand for towns, it makes no difference whatsoever. Say yes, this is the only thing we will repeat over and over again during our stays in your dreams at night, during our resonances during the day. All this can only be done to stabilize and really promote the spread of the yes. You will no longer be able to doubt, whatever your doubts may be today. You will no longer be able to question whatever your questions may be. Everything will clearly appear to you as something extremely simple, extremely evident, and extremely real, much more than the reality of the dream. The reality of the dream will move away from you without any difficulty. I repeat, you have nothing to do, just to be where you are, to live every minute with such intensity, to say yes to every minute. And anything that can still bother you, whether in your body, in your life, will no longer be. No problems can be maintained. No difficulties can reappear. This is the greatness of love. This is the greatness and magnificence of the truth. That's what I wanted to tell you. My intervention is limited because it can be summed up in one word, yes. And we sing for you, and we sing with you, the song of the yes, and the resonance of the yes. You will no longer be able to doubt, whatever your doubts may be today. You will no longer be able to question whatever your questions may be. Everything will clearly appear to you as something extremely simple, extremely evident, and extremely real, much more than the reality of the dream. The reality of the dream will move away from you without any difficulty. I repeat, you have nothing to do, just to be where you are, to live every minute with such intensity, to say yes to every minute. And anything that can still bother you, whether in your body, in your life, will no longer be. No problems can be maintained. No difficulties can reappear. This is the greatness of love. This is the greatness and magnificence of the truth. That's what I wanted to tell you. My intervention is limited because it can be summed up in one word, yes. And we sing for you, and we sing with you, the song of the yes, and the resonance of the yes. A gate to everyone, a gate everywhere, there are no other possible choices, there are no other truths that can be maintained, than this absolute truth. Feham will now withdraw into you. We will begin this song of the yes. It will resound before the end of this first day of November. You will have countless proofs, in countless ways, as I said, in your dreams, in what you can perceive even, but also on everything you look at, on a plane visible as invisible. Feham blesses your presence at this instant of the dreams unfolding. Silence. Feham blesses everyone with the same equality wherever you are. Silence. Everything that will happen in these days for each of you is there only to bring joy to you, whatever you may think of it. This naked joy, this naked consciousness, which no longer depends on any story, any character, or any evolution or transformation of the mind and which has always been there. You will see that. You will be sure of this by living it a little more and sometimes more intensely every day. We accompany you and we are you every minute from Alpha to Omega. Feham and the people of water bless you with the blending of the waters from above and the waters from below. Silence. No homies kaya, agate Feham eba. Through Jean Lukuyung. Les Transformations. English Translation, LMF.